was feeling that something was terribly wrong with the world that we live in, but you couldn't figure out just what it was. Then you've come to the right place. Secret societies, mystery religions, and the Illuminati have been controlling our reality since the beginning of time. But not anymore, because there is an awakening happening, and you are about to become a part of it. Wake up.
Acts 1, 6 to 10, the ascension of Jesus. The writer speaks of Jesus being taken up into a cloud. Do you think the writer thought that the heavens were literally in the clouds?
Oh, yeah. Yeah, because in both Hebrew and Greek, the word for the heavens, shamaim, I think it is in Hebrew, and Uranos in Greek, name for the Titan, Uranos, right? Was the heavens embodied. They had this cosmology where there were levels of heaven. And one was the heaven in which the birds flew. One was the starry skies of the night. And then there was the universal ocean that the firmament was built to keep out. And then above all of that was the throne of God, the creator. And then later still, they had this Ptolemaic notion of the earth being surrounded by seven concentric crystal spheres, each one with a planet in it, like a jewel set in a glass bowl or something. And they figured God was at the top. So I think there's, like, if you said, well, I can't really buy that, I bet Jesus was just transferred to another dimension. Well, you're not, what you're doing is demythologizing the text there. That isn't what the writer must have thought. Either that, or he was using language in a totally, the same words in a totally different sense than anybody else was. So they certainly must have thought he was going up into the nearby sky. They wouldn't have thought Jesus, I mean, if he actually went into outer space, he'd still be going, right? They must have thought that. And Yuri Gagarin was right. You know, the first cosmonaut, he, as a good old commie, he was an atheist, and he said, I don't see any God up here. I guess the Christians are wrong. Well, yeah, sort of. So what are you going to say? That he's in another dimension, like the outer limits or something. What does that mean? If you say, well, it's like the multiverse hypothesis. Well, are you just saying he popped into the universe next door? I mean, that's like Mormonism saying that he just took off and landed in Central America. That's not an answer. Are you going to say, well, he was beamed up to a waiting mothership? There are groups like the Aetherius Society that say that. But that, I don't even dismiss the idea of aliens and flying saucers. There's nothing inherently implausible about that. But to